Hi fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today we are going to continue with creating skin in 3ds Max CAD for this 3D model of a humanoid mech. This is a part 3 and the last one of the series, so if you didn't watch the previous parts, it would probably be better to watch those first. But let's move on. We will again continue exactly where we finish in the last part. Artist Rudy Baldi is the creator of this model and you can check more of his stuff on his website, link provided below the video. You can also download this complete model on my website for free. So we finished skinning the leg and most of the torso. Let's continue with the head. This shouldn't be too hard, we have three bones here, head, neck and chest. So we want to distribute the edge loops between them. There is some kind of mesh inside the neck, which I have found out just now, but I decided to leave it there. I have started with the middle neck loop, to find out how I want the whole neck to be weighted. I have realized it will have to be somewhere around 75%, and after I figured this out, I decided to skin this from bottom up. 3ds Max does this weird bug, or maybe it's intentional, I don't know, that near 100% values are not displayed red, but it's this yellow color. So I usually take paintbrush and paint the weights to be 100% value so I can clearly see them and to be a bit less confusing. You can see I again added an animation to the skin test layer, twisting of the head. Now I'm just watching what doesn't move as it should. You can clearly see that these three vertices should be affected by the neck as well, not just the chest. This upper part doesn't have to be affected by chest at all. I have selected the middle loop again to change its weight. But you see, there is a problem with the mesh. Some of these vertices are not welded together. Or maybe it was intentional, it doesn't matter to us. Just select them as well. So we want this loop to be affected mostly by neck bone, but also by head and chest. I ended up with these values, the biggest weight on neck, some on head and very little on chest. Now just blend these two vertices to similar values like those loops above and below them have. And finish the back part as well. Now the lower part should be all done, we can move to the upper one. Basically everything above neck should have 100% weights for head, because head shouldn't ever deform unless you are doing something specific. And we just need to blend in the neck part. I selected all vertices in this loop and tried out some values to see how it looks. After I felt okay, I just selected rest of the head vertices and put in 100% value, like I said. Now let's deal with this stuff inside the model. I copied the value of the closest vertex and pasted it on all of those inside. However, part of the object was still clipping out, so I eased in those vertices a bit. Nothing special. Okay, so the head is done, let's move on. I have noticed some of these vertices on the right leg were affected by the left leg. So I zeroed them out. Here it doesn't matter if you subtract the value, even though in previous tutorials I said you should always just add values, not subtract them. But here we don't care to which part of the right leg will those values be added, because we didn't skin that leg and we are going to mirror weights from left to the right leg anyway. We just don't want them to be affected by left leg. Okay, let's move to arms. And let's start with palm. This part isn't very complicated. It's mostly just blending two bones together, which is the easiest part in skinning. Put in some values and watch how the mesh deforms, and edit until you feel okay with the result. I again added additional animations for these knuckle bones, so I can see them separately when skinning. And this part is even simpler, because the whole elements of mesh are weighted with 100% values to their bones. However, here I again was not satisfied with the bone placement for this finger. If you watch this area, the joint is coming out of its socket, so we have to move the bone. This is something I showed in previous part as well, and I have even done a separate video for it, because people doesn't seem to know it. You need to disable Always Deform and Skin Modifier after that. Then, in setup mode, you can move the bone. And after you are done, reactivate Always Deform and Skin Modifier. Now you see the movement is much better. So, finish the rest of the fingers. Always check if everything looks alright. With skinning, you often find problems only after you start animating. You can find out that some particular pose doesn't work with the skin you have done, but you can always edit it even if you started animating. And you often will. Here I pasted the left arm to the right side, because I changed that finger only on the left one. Don't forget to always do that if you change something on one side. And here again another one. Elbow joint in the wrong place. So the same process again. Disable Always Deform and Skin Modifier. Move the bone. Paste to the other arm. And re-enable everything back. Okay, so now to the hardest part of arms, the shoulder. Start with the easier things. With vertices you are pretty sure belong to the arms and are not shared. After that, work towards the inside. You just have to try things out. Again, I realized this whole part of the mesh should be weighted just on the arm. And I ended up with these sharp transitions, which are not good. So now it's about blending in the values. Not much to say here, you just do what you did till now and figure out where should the vertices belong to. It's never going to be perfect, and that's actually the point of skinning. Stuff needs to deform, and it will. You just want to make it so it is deforming in the most pleasing way possible. Okay, so after you are done, don't forget to mirror the weights to the other side. I always select one of the bones from the other side before I hit mirror, to be sure it actually went through. Because after you hit that button, you can see that the weights actually changed and that it went correctly. After this, we are all done. Reapply the texture and good job, character is ready for animation. If you would like to see more stuff like this Hiroshima mech model and more free content for everybody, support me on Patreon or with any other way you would prefer, or just share the video. Thank you. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.